817 is your time right now. If you're thinking about buying a new home, there's lots of information out there to make sure you have all your ducks in a row. Money Coach Bill Stanley here with us this morning.
Good morning, yes.
Got to have those ducks ready, right?
That's right. You and your spouse may be looking for a place to live.
Right.
You got to know what to do.
And what should people know about becoming first-time homeowners?
Well, first of all, you got to know if you can afford a house. Uh-huh. You've got to have more money coming into your budget than going out of your budget.
Right.
Sounds simple, but a lot of people don't know. You've got to have a good credit score. I recommend in the 700s.
Okay.
You got to be able to pay your credit card debt off at the end of each month, because if you can't, you're in financial trouble now. You got to fix that problem.
Right.
You've got to have saved up enough money for a down payment. I'd like to see
20%. 20% is a good number?
Yes.
Yeah.
You've got to get your money, have an emergency fund in case your income is interrupted.
Now, what about getting some home buying education? That's important, right?
There is a seminar for first-time home buyers put on by the Consumer Credit Counseling Service.
Okay.
I recommend it highly. It's for first-time or second-time or fifth-time home buyers. I went to one a couple years ago with a refugee family and learned an awful lot. People with low income, there are options out there to buy houses. If you're looking online to find out what the house may be worth, I would avoid an appraisal system where you use the square footage.
Yeah, so square footage, that's, people think that, you know, that's what it's all about, but you have to really get a good appraisal, don't you?
Right. I talked to a realtor and an appraiser several weeks ago, and they said you've got to look at location, you've got to look at the layout of the house, you've got to look at traffic, you've got to look at the schools. There's an awful lot of things that you got to look at. And you also, you got to remember that the market value of the house is just that, what you will pay for it and what the owner will accept.
Right.
So you got to go from there. Since the financial crisis, there's been federal regulations that prohibit an appraiser from being given price guidelines. And this is a very good thing, because there are a lot of houses underwater out there where the appraisals were way too high.
And tell me a little bit about an appraisal that's a good appraisal, you know,
well,
with these new guidelines and everything.
You can either have a drive-by appraisal or you can have a full appraisal. And a full appraisal is generally required by the lender, because they're the ones that pay for the appraisal in the first place.
Right.
A drive-by is just that. You drive by, look at the house, and come up with a number. A full appraisal, the appraiser goes into the house and spends a couple hours and looks at every aspect of the house. Then they check the sales of comparable buildings from a mile radius for the last 6 months.
Right.
And they also have access to rebuild information. So they put all this together and give you a really good appraisal. So that's a very important part of the home buying process. So in summary, you know, I suggest people sit down and look at whether they can afford a house. Go to this seminar for first-time home buyers and then spend a lot of time looking at a lot of houses before they make the decision, because this is a big expense.
Absolutely.
And you're going to be there for a long time.
More information for Money Coach Bill, you can go to his website. It's moneycoachbill.org. You can see the site there on your screen, and he'll have much more information. You can contact him as well at moneycoachbill@aol.com.
Okay.
Sounds good. Thanks for coming, sir.
All right.
Appreciate it. All right, let's